Hello students, today we are going to discuss the chapter Saying Without Speaking. Have you heard about Damsharas? Let us play a game. In this game, everyone has to let others know what they want to tell without speaking. Divide yourself into groups of seven. Here, you can divide yourself into group of seven and you can play this game in your class. Your teacher will give each group a piece of paper with a situation written on it. Your teacher will write a situation and the situation will be given to each group. Each group will read what is written on the paper and prepare a silent act. And according to the situation given, the group has to prepare a silent act. Keep in mind that you cannot speak. You can express through your face and body action. Here in this act, you need not to speak. You should not speak. You have to express yourself with actions only. Mime, you see? You must have seen mime in your annual function. When all the groups are ready with their act, they have to perform one by one in front of other group. Now it's time for action. Time of action. Now each group has to show their act in front of others. The others will have to guess what is being acted out, and others have to guess the situation which has been acted by that particular group. How did you like this game? After seeing the game, playing the game, you have to tell, did you like this game or not? Games are always soothing, isn't it? Did you find it difficult to act without speaking? Now you have to tell if you feel any difficulty in preparing the act or expressing the act without speaking. Look at the picture given on the next page. The children in the picture are talking to each other through actions. Now let's see the pictures on the other side of the page. Here you can see two children are talking to each other with the actions only. They are talking with the hand actions only. Have you ever seen anyone talking through actions? Or when do people need to talk like this? Let's discuss it. Students, whenever a person who is not able to speak, that is, he or she may be dumb, they have to talk like this, that is, with the actions only. And sometimes when somebody is sleeping or when we have to hide ourselves, we have to talk through actions, isn't it? So two situations are there, when we want to hide ourselves and when somebody is not able to speak, that is, he or she may be dumb. Then people talk like this, that is, through hand actions or the body actions. Most of us can hear and speak, but there are some people who can neither hear nor speak. Do you know, students, we can easily hear and speak also, but there are some unlucky person who cannot hear or speak. These people talk through actions. They understand what the other person is saying by studying their lip movements. They have to concentrate on the lip movement of the other person, and by reading the lip movement, they can understand what the other person is saying. All of us cannot do everything. Some of us sing well, others write good poetry, some can climb trees quickly, while others can run fast. So these are the some of the qualities that people have. Everybody cannot do everything, isn't it? But everybody is good in doing something. Some can sing well. One of you may be good singer, one of you may be good dancer, or one of you can be a good poet. Some can climb trees very quickly, while others can run fast. So everybody has a particular special quality. Some can draw well, others can sing in tune. We are all special in our own ways. So in our own way, in a special way, we all are special. Hence in schools, we can learn from each other. Like all children, children who cannot speak and hear also go to school to read and write. In schools, sign language is taught to them. So these children who cannot hear or speak, they also go to school, and in the school, sign language is taught to them. Sign language is the language of hands and body action. Students, you can understand by seeing the picture. In this picture, when students are talking with the help of hand action, in the same way as we had done in the game, where the groups are not to speak, they have to act silently. At that time, you had used sign language. This is sign language. Let us read about a child who cannot hear, yet who can do many things. Now, let us meet a child who cannot hear, but still he is able to do a lot of things. This child is introduced in the form of a poem. I have a sister, my sister cannot hear. I have a sister, my sister is deaf. The person who cannot hear is called as deaf. Student, you should know. Who is deaf? She is special. There are not many sisters like mine. She is deaf, but she is very special to me, and there are no such persons, not many such persons. My sister can play the piano. She likes to feel the deep rumbling chords. She cannot hear. Still, she is able to play piano. But she will never be able to sing. But she cannot sing. She cannot hear the tune. Because she cannot hear the tune, that is why she cannot sing. But she can play the piano. She likes to leap, to tumble, to roll, to climb to the top the monkey bars. And she is able to leap, tumble. That means she is normal as other children, but the only thing is that she cannot hear. Now, my sister has started going to my school, although our mother still helps her lip read at home. So, in such cases, her mother teaches her lip movement, to read lip movement, but now she has started going to school. The teacher and children do not understand every word she says, like sister or water or thumb. Now, everybody is not expert in understanding the sign languages. That is why everybody is not able to understand what she wants to say, but they try. I wore my sunglasses yesterday. The frame were I wore my sunglasses yesterday. The frames were very large. The lenses are very black. My sister made me take them off when I spoke. Now, I have a sunglasses and I was wearing sunglasses yesterday and its frame were very, very large. The lenses are black. My sister made me take them off when I spoke. What do my brown eyes say to her brown eyes? Now, I just not speak, only told her to put them off by my eyes, and she understood. She helped me to take them off. I don't know what my eyes told her eyes, but she understood what I had told her. So students, it is true that the people or person or children who cannot speak, even they can also talk. How can they talk? They can talk with the action of their hands as well as the body movement, right? Our eyes tell a lot. Small children tell a lot through their face and hands even before they learn to speak. They understand a lot too. So students, just remember, the little children who can't speak, even if they don't speak, they can tell what they want. They can express it through their eyes and face movement. And surprisingly, we also understand them, what they want to say. That is why it is said that the face is a mirror. Observe children of about 6 to 8 months in your area. How do they express themselves? Now, you can observe the children, small children who are 6 to 8 months old, or your sibling, your small brother or sister. Just observe them and you will able to know that you can understand their feelings and what they want. You must be wondering what kind of faces these are. They have no eye, no nose, no mouth. You have to make these, but only after reading what is written alongside. Now, this is an activity for you. You have to read what has been written. Let us read. This is Aftab. His favorite toy has fallen down and broken. Oh, so sad. He is sad. How will his face look? Now, what you have to do, you have to make a sad face of Aftab. Let's go further. Here is Julie. Her little sister was born just yesterday. She is very excited. How will her face look? Now, the next one is for you to draw a exciting face. A face which expresses the feeling of excitement. So, you have to make the face of Julie. This is Yamini's mother. Today, while Yamini was taking out the bottle of pickle from the kitchen, it fell down from her hand and broke. Draw the look on her mother's face. Now, children, just imagine of Yamini's mother when Yamini has broken a bottle of pickle in the kitchen. How do Yamini's mother feel? Oh yes, she is very, very angry. So you have to draw an angry face of Yamini's mother. Who's the next now? Yes, this is Rehana. She is afraid of dogs. While playing, suddenly a dog came in front of her. How will Rehana's face look? Now, you may or may not be scared of dogs, but some students, some children are scared of dogs and other pets also. Here is Rehana, who is also afraid of dogs. And suddenly when she was playing, a dog came in front of him. And now, how will she be looking like? Yes, Rehana's face will be shocked, afraid. So, yeah, here you have to draw a feared off face of Rehana. So, students, in this way, you have to complete this activity by drawing the faces with the given expressions. By looking at someone's face, we can tell if the person is happy, sad, or angry. Isn't it? Yes, it is true that we can read the faces. We can see what expressions were there on the face. So, we will be able to know if the person is happy, sad, or angry. Has it ever happened that you had done some mischief and your mother found out just by looking at your face? Yes, it must be happened to everybody. Sometimes you want to hide something, but your face tells everything. Your mother or your teacher or your father can read your face. You can't hide anything through your face. Even if you want to hide something, your face tells the truth. We can talk through dance as well. Now, the next thing is that students, first we have learned that the people who can't speak, they can speak through their action of their hands and body. Secondly, their face with the expressions on their face. And let us go further, as dance also tells something. Dance also gives the expressions. Are used to convey feelings. These are called mudras and bhavas. So, while dancing, dancers shows various expressions which are called as mudras and bhavas. So, these are called mudras and bhavas by the dancer. Look and do these mudras. Learn some more dance mudras and do them. Now you can see some of the dance mudras here with the hand movement. You can also learn some more mudras. Look, children, here you can see some more mudras of dance. You have to observe them and try to copy them. A last activity that has been given in your book is look at these pictures and guess. Make your own story, tell the story to your friends and discuss. Here some picture cards has been given. First, second, third and fourth. Now students, this you have to do it yourself. You have to make a story of your own and write it down and tell to everybody else. So this was all about speaking without saying without speaking. I hope you understand the chapter. Thank you.